All right, so this card that I'm making today is going to be for the Obscure Holiday Hop to commemorate National Puzzle Day. And that day is celebrated on the 29th of January. And it basically just recognizes how important it is to exercise our brains, either by using or by doing jigsaw puzzles, which I have this punch here. And so we're going to punch out a bunch of pieces of these card stocks. These are from Lawn Fawn that were freebies when I did some orders. And I feel like these are kind of like fitting because in my mind, doing puzzles is like a wintertime type of cozy hobby to have or whatever pastime. So I'm going to cut strips or punch out strips of these, this cable knit sweater looking one. And there, that looks like a very wintry pattern as well. So, we are just going to punch out some of these. This isn't wintry, but this, I don't know how much of this you'll be able to see with this teeny tiny punch, but let's see. Let's see. Where's the cozy word? Maybe on this side. Oh, it doesn't really come up. You can't really see it, can you? No. Oh, and I guess I should watch out where I. Okay, let's try this again. Okay. Yeah, so the puzzle pieces are pretty freaking tiny, so you can't really see much of anything. So maybe this one isn't really the vibe, because you can't really see. See, it's not really helpful. So maybe we will skip this one, even though I thought it'd be really cute. Maybe we'll use this for some other part of the card, because I kind of want it to be Lawn Fawn focused. So, since these are super tiny, we're gonna have to do a whole bunch of punching. So I am going to put this on hyper record speed and die or punch out a whole bunch of these. I used to have a bigger puzzle piece punch, but it is gone, so I don't know if I got rid of it because I never used it or what, but that's what we're gonna do. I'll be back after all this is punched out. All right, so just a little more information on the hop that I'm participating in. This hop is the Obscure Holiday Hop, and it is organized over on Instagram. So I will leave the information for the organizer on the in the description box below. So if you are interested, you can join us next month. Basically, what we do is we just we try to bring to light a fun holiday that is not as widely celebrated. And it's just a hop that's for fun and to try to bring appreciation to more
All right, so
holidays.
what I'm going to do here is I had a brilliant idea to try to do a hot foiling technique. This is with the deco foil. So what I decided I was going to try to do, and I'm going to accommodate for it not working by stamping my happy birthday stamp that I made with the Henry Jr. ABCs. I'm going to stamp it in black ink just in case my project idea here doesn't work. But all right, so the idea that I'm going to do after I stamp this in the VersaFine Onyx black ink, just so that I can cover my bases, is I'm going to try to use the duo gel for hot foiling with the deco foil. I'm going to try to stamp with that. I've not seen anyone try to do this before, but we're going to give it a shot and see how it goes. So we're stamping this in the VersaFine Onyx black ink, and we're using the pressure tool to press it down. But then after that, we are going to smear a very, very thin layer of the deco for or the duo gel onto this clear acrylic block. I'm going to use a palette knife and just very thinly smear that onto the palette or onto that clear acrylic block. I thought about doing it on my gel plate, but I didn't want to wreck the gel plate. I didn't know if it would wreck the gel plate or not. I just knew that it would probably come off of this easier. So, in hindsight, though, I would have made this a much thinner layer of this the duo gel stuff because it does not need to be as thick as I made it there. I did make it too thick. So yeah, I cleared my knife back into the tub And there we are smooshing it gently onto the stamps. And I just want to make sure that I get like good coverage. And this is literally just an experiment. Y'all are playing along with me. So, yeah. So basically what I'm going to do now is I'm going to stamp it onto that craft cardstock. And it looks pretty decent. So at this point, I'm going to let that dry and go wash off my stamp block and stuff. And then we are going to use some red deco foil to run it through my mink machine. And here is the moment of truth. After we run this bad boy through the mink machine, let's see how it goes. Ta-da! Now that's not terrible. I kind of like it. I'm going to use it because, you know, I don't know what I expected, but at least it's legible. Like, that's cool. I will try this technique again in the future. So, super fun. And I did try to just, like, burnish a little more foil onto that Y there, but it didn't work. Oh, well. It's good enough. I think it's pretty cool. All right, so here it is, the foiled sentiment that I made with the Duo Transfer Gel. And one thing I will say is if you're going to try this technique, make sure that you are able to clean your stuff up right away because that Duo Transfer Gel starts getting sticky right away. But there it was in the black ink. And then here we are. I'm going to use this banner punch that I have to trim it down. And I don't like how wide the strip is because of the sentiment not being that wide. So we're going to trim it down and then redo the banner end. And yeah, but I can't stress that enough. If you are going to try this technique, make sure that you are able to wash your stamps and your all the things off right away. Because that Duo Gel gets sticky quickly. And yes, in case you're wondering, in case you noticed, in this part of the video, I am wearing pajamas with cats on them. They were a Christmas gift from my kids. And I love them. All right, so this, I put it on super speed again to show you arranging the puzzle pieces all around the outside of this card panel. And I'm a fan of how I decided to use the sweater weather or whatever it is, cozy vibes, whatever the heck it says. And then I'm going to pop that sentiment up on some foam tape. And then we are going to mount it to a craft colored card base. And then that is the finished card. We're going to set something heavy on it to let it dry. And yes, I was thinking about it as I was making this, that all those puzzle pieces are all different. So this would not make for a very good puzzle. That would be the most frustrating puzzle ever. Thank you so much for watching. Here is your 5 seconds of Sonic. And yes, before you get concerned, I did get him out of that bag immediately after I took the 5 second video that you just saw. So yeah, he was good, but he loves getting inside things. Thank you so much for watching, and leave a comment down below with what is your favorite type of, like, brain teaser puzzle. Mine is Sudoku currently.